Joining us today, Expedition 4142 flight engineer Elena Serova. Elena, thank you very much for your time. It's a busy time for you. You're in the home stretch of your training for your launch in September on the Soyuz to the International Space Station. How excited are you at this point, and what are you looking forward to the most once you arrive on the International Space Station for your time up there?
Well, most of all, I am expecting to perform my work with great quality, and I'm a little concerned that I really want to stand up for those people who helped me to prepare for this mission and to help me to perform my work in a good manner.
Tell us a little bit about yourself, Elena. What got you interested in human spaceflight, becoming a cosmonaut? What are some of your hobbies as well when you have free time?
Well, I'd like to start with the first part of your question, why I became interested in flying into space. Since I was a child, I was very interested in space, the entire topic of space, everything that was related to space exploration. And the great part in my decision was placed by my school and my first teacher, who often told us about different events related to space exploration. So it was the first part in my conscious decision. After that, I went to study in the Moscow Aviation Institute, the Space Exploration Department. It was a very purposeful choice on my part. I was very much interested in everything that was related to cosmonauts and astronauts. After that, I joined the RSC Energia as an engineer. And when I had an opportunity to apply to become a cosmonaut, actually a cosmonaut candidate, I did that. And now I'm here talking to you. As to the second part of your question, I have different interests, and they are not only space-related, as you might imagine. I love archaeology and history. And I like it so much because I think that a human person who knows his or her history has their roots, and they have their outlook for the future.
Let's talk a little bit about history for a moment. When we interview cosmonauts, we ask them, what got you inspired? What was your motivation to want to fly in space? Did you have a hero when you were young? And they all say, of course, Yuri Gagarin. For you, was it Yuri Gagarin, or might it have been Valentina Tereshkova that enabled you to look up at the sky and say, I can do that one of these days?
Let me answer in this way. Of course, a big part in my decision was made by all the cosmonauts who were flying first, both men and obviously women. And Valentina Tereshkova was the woman. She was a great example that impacted my decision in the future. A lot of people played part in my decision, and there were American astronauts and both female and male.
Elena, you will become only the fourth Russian woman to fly in space when you launch, and the first since Elena Kondakova flew on the space shuttle back on her second flight into space some 14 years ago. How significant is this for you personally, and what is the importance of your flight opening up the door, perhaps, for more Russian women to become cosmonauts in the future?
Let me answer this question like this. The door to space was opened to all women by Valentina Tereshkova. we only do our work. I don't think I'm doing anything extraordinary. I'm just doing something that was started by our female astronauts, cosmonauts. I think that both cosmonauts and astronauts, first of all, should be professionals in their area in order to perform their work in exemplary manner.
Has your training been more complex than you had anticipated? So many things to learn, Russian segment, U.S. segment, all of the scientific work that you'll be conducting during your 6 months on orbit. How complex has all of this preparation been for the opportunity to fly in space?
Usually when I'm asked this question, I answer it like this. No work is easy, especially training and learning is hard. It is a very hard job to do, and my path up to this moment has been very difficult. And I think that my work in the future will be very tense and very challenging. Whenever you are faced with these challenges, you have to make decisions, and it's very interesting. I love learning. I really like it and enjoy it. It's not difficult to learn, but no work is easy, as I said.
Have you spent any free time thinking about what the view of Earth is going to be once you get up on the space station? How magnificent this whole experience is going to be for you to have the opportunity to look back at Earth, to look at your home country, to experience weightlessness for 6 months?
Yes, of course. I have been thinking about that, and I was trying to imagine what it would be like. As my Russian colleagues and U.S. colleagues told us, whatever you see from out there is unforgettable. And I'm hopeful to get this experience in my life, and I will enjoy the Earth views. My homeland is our planet, and I hope to get this experience.
Elena, in the wake of becoming only the fourth Russian woman to fly in space later this year, do you see yourself as a role model? You mentioned Valentina Tereshkova, of course, as a role model for women, but do you see yourself in the future as a role model for other Russian women to have also an opportunity to mark their place in history?
I hope so. And I hope that I will be a role model not only for women, girls, young girls, but also for men, that I will be a good example to follow. Because, like I said, it's a huge responsibility.
The International Space Station just passed the 15th anniversary of the launching of the Zarya module, the first component of the space station. And it has just now been extended, its lifetime has been extended to at least 2024. How have you viewed the space station's maturation, how it's grown in size, grown in research capability? What does it represent for you in terms of a place to live and work?
From the very first launch, the station has grown. The station is big now. We have a lot of science hardware there in order to perform all kinds of scientific experiments and research. And I hope that in the future, that hardware will growing in amount and will be able to perform a lot of different functions. And obviously, experienced people will be using that hardware for research. So I just want to say that I really hope that it will be so.
How has the International Space Station made it possible for various nations, various cultures, languages, backgrounds, astronauts, cosmonauts from all over the world, that it has become sort of a global village, if you will? It almost is like the Olympics in its own right, bringing all these nations together. How significant is all of that?
Это безусловно важно то, что
It is undoubtedly very important that we have all kinds of people working on the International Space Station, people from different countries, people of different professions, because the International Space Station is the beginning of something tremendous, something outstanding, especially in the light of the further exploration, when people will be exploring other planets and other worlds. And people like exploring. People are natural travelers and explorers. I think the International Space Station is a very important step in the history of mankind.
Elena Serova, thank you so much for your time. Expedition 4142, flight engineer Elena Serova, and good luck with your training as you prepare for your launch. Thank you.
Спасибо вам большое.
Thank you very much.
Dust mask.
Мы можем эту и ту использовать, я помню это. We can use this one.
Somebody go to the nearest, which is right here in the lab. The PCS. Go ahead and hit the alarm from the PCS.
Yes. 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 Yes.
No EPS trip. Record failed hardware. One overhead. One. AAA.
Yeah.
That's the one that is right there. Or open.
There's another key that's happening. We'll talk about it.
Sure.
Besides the WPA, look at this message. So that's lab one, red one, lab one.
Good call. Node one after it's closed. Oh.
Оно не меняется.
А где написано инструменты каунт? То есть начинаешь с вот скобочек, видишь, как написано?
Я думаю, вижу эти.
So я думаю. Ситуация так, что и.
Я же справлюсь. Но это я с учетом надолго.
скафандр снимет.
Она еще при посадке
снимет. Она быстро из него вылазит.
Сила привычки. Здесь посылают в космос. Здесь посылают.
Уберите пятую точку из карты. Иванов, пятую точку уберите.
Все нормально. Отлично.
Да, у меня все по описи.
Шилет не лишний.
Ну, заряд проходной проверки.
Ноги.